Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in previous videos we have studied what are the various losses in the transformer. We have also studied the polarity test. In this video we are going to study the open circuit and short circuit test. This test is mostly useful in determining all the circuit parameters for the equivalent circuit. In order to determine the equivalent circuit parameters, open circuit and short circuit tests are conducted. These tests are also useful in determining the performance of the transformer. Now basically we know that in transformer there are two main losses, iron loss and copper loss. Out of this, iron loss depends upon voltage, whereas copper loss depends upon current. By performing the two tests, that is open circuit test and short circuit test, we can determine the value of these losses as well as various circuit parameters of the equivalent circuit. Now first, let us study the open circuit test. The circuit diagram for the open circuit test is as shown in figure. Here, the single phase supply is given to the variac. Variac is nothing but variable transformer or auto transformer. This is mostly used in order to vary the voltage which we are going to provide to the transformer windings. Then the ammeter A is connected in series with the wattmeter. Now the wattmeter basically has four terminals, M, L, C and V. Here M represents main, L represents line, C represents common and V represents voltage. The L terminal of wattmeter is connected to the primary winding. Then the V terminal is connected to the terminal of voltmeter. Similarly, one end of the L terminal is connected to the positive terminal of voltmeter. The negative terminal is connected to the V terminal. Also, the same terminal goes to our negative of supply. Here, the supply is given to the LV side, whereas HV side is kept as open. Hence, in this case, the primary winding is open, hence the test is called as open circuit test. Now, as we are performing the open circuit test, what we have to do is, we have to consider what is the rated voltage of the primary winding, vary the auto transformer until we get the value of rated voltage. Hence, the rated voltage is supplied to the primary winding of the transformer. When the rated voltage is supplied to the primary winding of the transformer, if we see the secondary transformer is open circuited, hence a very small value of current I0 flows through the ammeter. This current is called as no load current. The value of this no load current is nearly 2% to 5% of the full load rated value of the primary current. As we can see, we are supplying the rated voltage of the primary winding, but the current that is indicated by the ammeter is very low. Now, I have already told you that the iron loss depends upon voltage, whereas copper loss depends upon current. As the value of current is very negligible, the value of copper loss is also negligible, hence it can be neglected. As it is, we can say that the wattmeter W will record the iron losses. These iron losses can be indicated by wattmeter W. The voltmeter will indicate the value of rated voltage. Now let us see how to determine the parameters by using this test. All the readings of the instruments connected for the test can be given by ammeter gives the value of no load current, that is I0. Voltmeter gives the value of rated voltage, that is V1. Whereas wattmeter gives the value of iron loss, that is PI. Now the formula for the iron loss. Now the value of iron loss as indicated by the wattmeter can be written as PI is equal to V1 I0 cos phi 0. Here cos phi 0 is the value of no load power factor. Rearranging equation 1, we can write the formula for cos phi 0 as cos phi 0 is equal to PI divided by V1 into I0. Let it be equation number 2. Now we know that from the equivalent circuit diagram, the parallel branches of R0 and X0 are connected to the no load side of the transformer. Hence, now we will find what is the formula for the magnetizing current and what is the formula for the working current. The formula for the working current can be written as IW is equal to I0 cos of phi 0. Similarly, the formula for magnetizing current can be written as I mu is equal to I0 sine of phi 0. Combining IW and I mu, the formula for the no load current can be written as I0 is equal to square root of IW square plus I mu square. Similarly, the formula for the resistance R0 can be written as R0 is equal to V1 divided by IW. Similarly, formula for X0 can be written as X0 is equal to V1 divided by I mu. Hence, by using the open circuit test, we can find all these parameters. Now, let us study the short circuit test. Short circuit test is basically done to determine the copper losses as well as equivalent parameters of the equivalent circuit. In this test, the supply is given to HV winding, whereas LV winding is short circuited by using a thick copper wire. Let us see the circuit diagram for short circuit test. Single phase AC supply is given to the variac. Variac is nothing but the auto transformer or any transformer that can provide the variable voltage. Then, one voltmeter and one ammeter are connected. There is also one wattmeter. The four terminals of wattmeter are MLCV, which is connected to the HV winding of the transformer, whereas the LV winding is short circuited. Now, the procedure to follow the short circuit test is like this. First of all, what we have to do is we have to find the value of rated primary current. Once we find the value of rated primary current, we have to vary the voltage unless ammeter gives the value of rated current. This value of voltage is very small as compared to the rated primary voltage. Once the ammeter gives the value of rated primary current, we have to record the values of ammeter, that is current. Then voltmeter will give the value of short circuit voltage. Now, in this case, we can see that the transformer is taking the rated current, but the voltage is very small as compared to its rated voltage. Hence, in this case, the transformer will only show the copper loss, because copper loss is directly proportional to voltage, and the iron losses can be neglected because the value of voltage is very low. Hence, the wattmeter which is connected to the primary winding will indicate the copper loss. Now let us see how to determine the various parameters. The various readings obtained from the instruments connected for the short circuit test can be written as: the ammeter will indicate the value of short circuit current, that is rated current ISC. Voltmeter will indicate the value of short circuit voltage VSC. Whereas the wattmeter will indicate the value of copper loss, that is full load copper loss PCFL. Now, the formula for the copper loss obtained from the wattmeter can be written as PCFL is equal to VSC ISC cos phi SC. Here, cos phi SC is the power factor at the rated condition. Rearranging equation 1, we can write the formula for cos phi SC as cos phi SC is equal to PCFL divided by VSC into ISC. Now, let us find the value of equivalent resistance RE1. RE1 is equal to PCFL divided by ISC square. Similarly, formula for the equivalent impedance is given by ZE1 is equal to VSC divided by ISC. Now, the formula for the equivalent reactance XE1 can be written as XE1 is equal to under root ZE1 square minus RE1 square. Now, if you want to transfer this value as compared to secondary, then we have to find the value of transformation ratio. The transformation ratio is given by N1 by N2 is equal to V1 by V2 is equal to I2 by I1 is equal to alpha. Now let us transfer the values of RE1, XE1 and ZE1 as referred to secondary. The value of ZE2, that is the equivalent impedance of transformer referred to secondary, can be written as ZE2 is equal to ZE1 multiplied by N2 by N1 square. Now we know that N1 by N2 is alpha, hence N2 by N1 square is nothing but 1 upon alpha. So, by modifying this equation, we get ZE2 is equal to ZE1 divided by alpha square. Similarly, the value of RE2 can be written as RE2 is equal to RE1 multiplied by N2 by N1 square. Hence, we can modify this equation as RE2 is equal to RE1 divided by alpha square. Similarly, the formula for XE2 can be written as XE2 is equal to XE1 multiplied by N2 by N1 square. Further modifying this equation, we get XE2 is equal to XE1 divided by alpha square. Hence, by using the short circuit test, we can find out the value of copper loss, whereas the various circuit parameters such as equivalent resistance, equivalent impedance, and equivalent reactance. In this way, we have studied how to find the equivalent circuit parameters as well as the losses of transformer by using the open circuit and short circuit test. This test is very useful as very less input is taken in order to determine the performance of the transformer. Now, if we consider the open circuit test, in case of open circuit test, we can see that the supply is given to LV winding whereas the HV winding is kept open. The reason for this is that there are instruments in the laboratory which can measure the low voltage of the LV winding, whereas if we had considered giving supply to the HV winding, then the instruments to measure such high amount of voltage are not readily available. Hence, in case of open circuit test, the supply is given to LV winding whereas the HV winding is kept open. Now, if we consider the short circuit test, in case of short circuit test, the supply is given to HV winding whereas the LV winding is short circuited. The reason for this is that the current of the HV winding is less as compared to the current of the LV winding. Also, in short circuit test, we are providing the voltage unless we get the rated current. This value of voltage is very low as compared to the rated voltage. Hence, in case of short circuit test, supply is given to HV winding whereas LV winding is kept short circuited. Thank you friends for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ekeeda and do subscribe our channel Ekeeda. Thank you.